أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه ولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد we continue with the beautiful surah of القتال or سورة محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم and today we are with verses 29 all the way to the end inshallah rabbil alamin Allah azza wa jal talked to us about those who rejected the deen of Allah after it was presented to them this is last time in verse number 25 onwards that they left the deen and gave their backs to it That's the expression, figurative expression, that when somebody inviting you to something and you give your back and move away, that means you are not considering it important, you are not caring about it. So, ارتدوا على أدبارهم, they left the message of Rasulullah like that. When they die, the angels will punish them to get the ruh out. And we talked about that. The ruh refuses to leave this body when it knows where is it going. It's going for punishment. So it wants to stay in this body to fulfill the lusts and desires and enjoyment in this dunya. It does not want to leave for the azab of eternity. But the believer, they know that their jannah is waiting for them, so the ruh wants to go out. Leave. I done my job here in this body, in this dunya, so now I need to go get my reward in the eternity. So the ruh of the believer comes out easy. But the ruh of the kafir comes out very hard. Why? Because it knows now where is it going, right? So this body is the place of enjoyment. It does not want to go to a place of torture, so the angels keep slapping them and punishing them. So the ruh comes out. Why? Because they followed, ayah number 28, they followed what displeased Allah. And they rejected everything, they hated everything that pleases Allah. I want to give you something to take with you tonight, inshallah. Whenever you find that you are at ease in your heart with the a'mal of Allah Azza wa Jal, you know this is a good sign for you. When you start reading Quran and you find that you are okay with it, when you do salah and okay with it, when somebody presents you for something bad and you're not okay with it, it's a good sign. Say Alhamdulillah. But when you see that the a'mal of Allah becomes hard for you and the other things becomes comfortable and dearer to your heart means you have a problem. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Al-Hajj, وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِذَا هُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ When Allah alone is mentioned, You find that they are like, but when you mention something else, nice. Okay, so when we talk about akhirah, we say, "Akhi, why you have to talk to us?" But when we talk about the dunya and all that, mashallah, very good subject. So pay attention to these things. And may Allah save us from that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jal is telling us that this is what happens to them. Those munafiqeen and the hypocrites. Today is a continuity of that. أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضْ Do those who have disease in their heart, munafiqeen, أَلَّا munafiqeen, hypocrites. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضْ There is disease in their heart. Disease of the soul, Disease of the soul, not disease in the heart means they have heart problem or they need a stent or heart, no. Qulub here is not the flesh muscle here. لا, this is the qalb, which is part of the spiritual, the soul. When Allah told about aql, aql, see, I'm pointing to my brain here. But that's not the part only. This brain has a function, physical function. But the ruh has part that has the spiritual and mental function. Heart, I point my heart, said, I love this. You see, pointing to my heart. Oh, I feel my chest is tight. Huh? This physical has some explanation, but we are talking about soul. Okay? So it has both sides. It's not physical only, it's not spiritual only, it's a mix of both. Okay? So Allah said, في قلوبهم مرض, they have a disease in their heart. They can be healthy, heart strong, but there is a disease in it. They are doubting. They have problems. Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, في قلوبهم مرض, فزادهم الله مرضا. Why? Because they deceiving Allah and they pretending to be something that they are not. Okay? So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, do those people think, أَلَّنْ يُخْرِجَ اللَّهُ أَضْغَانَهُمْ. أضغان, جمع of ضغينة. 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 جمع of what? ضغينة. The word here, ضغينة, means the grudge or the hatred in the heart. Grudge or the hatred in the heart, subhanAllah. Also, it is plural of the word dhghn. Dhghn. Dhghn or dhghina means hiqd shadid. Hiqd is like hatred or loathsome grudge, that you hate someone with a passion. Hiqd shadid, you hate with a passion. That is dhghn or dhghina. Said, I don't have any dhghina in my heart toward the Muslims. See? I'm saying, I don't have dhghina in my heart. Whatever we disagree, it will not reach to that level. But when you reach to that level, you don't want to see the person, you don't want to hear the person, you don't want to talk to the person, you don't want to hear their name, you don't want them to exist in front of you. You see, dhghina means? So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, those hypocrites, they hate Rasulullah and the Muslimin to that extent. Amazing. And they're living with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they hate like that. Said Allah, saying to them, do they think that they will hide from Allah? And if Allah wants to expose them, He will expose them. It is Allah have rahmah on them that they are not exposed, you know. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, He would have shown you, Ya Rasulullah, and all the believers, what these people truly are. Will show you their colors. وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَأَرَيْنَاكَهُمْ. If we wish, we would have shown them to you. وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَأَرَيْنَاكَهُمْ means would have shown you for sure. فَلَعَرَفْتَهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ. يعني we'll make a sign for them in their faces that you'll know this munafiq or not munafiq. See how Allah is covering them? Sometimes Allah has rahmah on the kuffar, but they don't know it. Sometimes Allah has rahmah on the hypocrites, but they don't know it. Allah has rahmah on us when we commit sins, but we don't know it. Imagine this, Allah telling Rasulullah, if we wish, we would have made the munafiqeen, they wake up in the morning and the hypocrisy is clear on their face. Everyone said, hypocrite, not hypocrite. Hypocrite, not hypocrite. Oh, now you are clean from hypocrisy. Oh, now you got hypocrisy. Become a problem, right? Imagine your sin has a smell. So every morning, people smell certain sin. You backbite, there is something shows in your face. Or something. Become a problem. Now you see the rahmah of Allah. We make mistake and He covers us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants us to repent. So please, before you sleep every day, make istighfar. Before you sleep, make istighfar. أستغفر الله العظيم كل ذنب العظيم وأتوب إليه. You know, I seek refuge in Allah from all sins, major and minors, and I repent to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's necessary for us, because maybe this is the last night. Maybe, last night. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم taught us, even when we have majlis, we do everything good, there is a dua. Rasulullah said, كفارة المجلس. You know كفارة? كفارة means when you do something wrong, right? كفارة. The كفارة of any majlis, maybe you said something you should not say. You say, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, اشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, استغفرك واتوب إليك. Every majlis. Before you leave, you say what? سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, اشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, استغفرك واتوب. Rasulullah said, if you do that at every majlis, Allah forgive whatever you said or something bad happens. Even you didn't say, say astaghfirullah. We understand the importance. Otherwise, Allah Azza wa Jalla covers waiting for us to repent. So don't finish a day without repenting of what you know or you don't know. Is that clear, inshallah? أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَلَّنْ يُخْرِجَ اللَّهُ أَضْغَانَهُمْ. Allah would show. وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَأَرَيْنَاكَهُمْ. If we wish, we'd have shown you their, you know, sign. فَلَعَرَفْتَهُمْ بِسِمَاهُمْ. But you will not know, because we did not show you. But Allah gave him a hint. وَلَتَعْرِفَنَّهُمْ You surely will know them في لحن القول. You know, لحن, mistake. يعني. In Tajweed, Dr. Khan, we say لحن. لحن means make mistake. Did not make إغضغام. Did not make إخفاء right. Make the mad shorter or longer. We say this is لحن. What is called? لحن. لحن, جلي, means clear لحن. Make فتحة ضمة, زبر, بيش, بيش, make it زير. Like that is لحن جلي, clear. لحن خفي, hidden لحن, means only those who know تجويد, they figure it out. آه, لحن. So Allah said, وَيَتَعْرِفَ أَنَّهُمْ فِي لَحْنِ الْقَوْلِ They don't talk straight. Because منافق lies, right? He wants to cover his tracks. So he'll end up not having straight speech. Mistake. Ah, and لحن also means tone. Melody. Melody. But why it's called the لحن? It's not here mistake. Means it is not the normal sound. Normal sound is a way, but you are arranging it in a different way, not common, to make a certain melody. So when we speak, I'm speaking now. But when I say, الحمد لله رب العالمين, that's a melody, right? What we call it, لحن. It is not, الحمد لله رب العالمين. You see, this is straight. Forward. But lahn has waves.
Chanting.
Yeah, chanting. So chanting is not normal, is not going with the norm of speech. So it is a deviation from the norm of speech, but it's a good one. But lahn al-qawl means the norm of speech, they're deviating in the wrong way. So lahn goes both ways, right? It can be melody or tone. It can be what? Lying or mistake. Yeah, lahn. So lahn can be mistake and lahn can be melody. Ah. So Allah said, وَلَتَعْرِفَنَّهُمْ فِي لَحْنِ الْقَوْلِ Sometimes the Arabs used to say, إِذَا كُنْتَ كَذُوبًا فَكُنْ ذَكُورًا إِذَا كُنْتَ كَذُوبًا If you are a liar, habitual liar, be a habitual remembering. You know, remember by habit. If you are a liar, you have to be a good memory. If you are a good liar, you have to have a good memory. إذا كنت كذوبا فكن ذكورا. يعني when you lie, write it down. Serious. Otherwise, you're gonna make a mistake and people will catch you even after 10 years. They will catch you. Okay? Someone was talking to me yesterday. They talked to me a week ago. And they say, Alhamdulillah, Shaykh, I'm gonna have a job. And that job is gonna pay me lots of money. And I can do it from home. I said, Wallahi, mashallah, give me this job, ya akhu, Allah. I want a job like that. I work from home. I make more money. I said, take it. I said, yeah, I'm making istikhara. And said, please go ahead, go do it. But, you know, now I'm making this job here and there. And I said, keep this job until you capture the other job, right? Okay. So Nick, yesterday calls. He said, Sheikh, I have a car problem. I said, all right. May Allah help you what you need. I need help this. I said, that's fine. Go get, you told me that you're going to get a job that gives you lots of money. So he said, but the new job needs a car. You see now, last week it was, doesn't need a car and it was work from home, will make lots of money. So now because the car is broken, the job needed what? But you get the point, right? So if you wanna lie, remember what you said. Because based on the lie, you're gonna build a castle. Okay? But when you say the truth is you don't have to remember it. You don't have to remember. You just say the truth, khalas, alhamdulillah. Even if you forget and you say something, you said, you know what? No, I forgot. And people will accept that. You know what I mean? Like if you said the truth and you come later and said, I thought you were like, he said, yes, you're right. That was right, now I'm wrong. You see? So you can fix it. But if you lie then, how are you going to fix it now? Either you're going to say I was lying, or either you're going to continue lying again. And you keep up going with that. وَلَتَعْرِفَنَّهُمْ فِي لَحْنِ الْقَوْلِ They're going to make a mistake. They're going to lie. So they come and say, our excuse, why did not come to the jama'ah? Oh, because I was tired and da-da-da-da-da-da. After 1 week, they will say, such and such day, something happened to me in the market. I thought you were in the house, tired. You know, so it is lahm al-qawl. You get the idea? So that's why you avoid lying. Believer cannot be liar. Because once you lie, you lose your credibility. You lose what? Your credibility. It's one time only people find out you're lying. Khalas. How would they know what you say is truth after that? So be careful of lying. Be careful of lying. If you forget, say I forgot. Alhamdulillah, forgot. I was not right. Wallahi, that makes you a better person, noble person. But do not emphasize on the lie. Munafiqeen do that. Wallahu, wala ta'rifannahum bisimam, wala ta'rifannahum fi lahn al-qawl, wallahu ya'lamu a'malakum. Yani a'mal is niyat, innama al-a'malu bin niyat. Allahu ya'lamu a'malakum, what it means. I know, I'm praying, Allah knows I'm praying. I'm giving zakah, Allah knows I'm giving zakah. Is this what it means? No. Means Allah knows why you did the a'mal. How you did the a'mal, what reason you did the a'mal for, yani that's the meaning. Allahu ya'lamu a'malakum, yani what is behind it. You cannot say, oh, Allah knows that we are studying Quran now. Of course Allah knows what's written in Quran now. We are studying, we know that too. Don't we? We are sitting here. I know that, you know that. But can anybody tell me what is the intention of each person? Nobody. Why I came here? Why I'm doing what I'm doing now? Nobody can know. Allah is the one who knows. Allah is the one who knows. Yeah, maybe I came for a nice dinner. Yeah. I ate today before I started the class. I was hungry. Maybe this is my plan. I'm going to go there and have the dinner. And okay, also I give them the lesson, you know. You don't know if this is my niyyah or not. I'm just giving you an example. Alhamdulillah, it's not my niyyah, right? It's actually my niyyah. I come here and the dinner is secondary. I'm not lying, yani. Dinner also is part of the package why I come. Don't get me wrong, yani. It is an incentive. It's not haram, by the way. People tell me, ya Shaykh, why you make food in the masjid Sunday morning? People come only for breakfast. I said, fine, we'll make breakfast then. Yani they tell me, like, people only come for food. I said, that's fine, I'll make food then, more food then. If more food brings more people, I want more people to come for breakfast, ya. And when the halqa is second priority, may Allah make it first priority later. At least they attend. At least they will give me their ear. Then their heart will follow, inshallah. But don't say no food, no people. لا, no, I want food and people. Then they work on their intention later on. I want kids to come for basketball and salah. Then it becomes salah later on. You get it? I want people to come for masjid for party. Then salah time comes, they come salah. Allah open their heart, inshallah, they see good people. So please do not close the doors in front of someone who coming for another thing. But what my point is, nobody knows the intention why we are here tonight. But we are here tonight. May Allah make our intention for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray to Allah. Since you are here now, say, ya Allah, accept from me. See? Since you came already. Why you came? That's between you and Allah. But now fix it. Now do what? Fix it. Chance. So Allah Azza wa Jal said, Wallahu ya'lamu a'malakum. And this also indicates, if Allah knows your deeds and your intention, it gives the indication that Allah will reward you accordingly. Because what is the ilm of Allah results in? Yani Allah knows you're reading Quran. Allah knows why you are reading Quran. And you know you are sincere. What is left? Reward. So trust that Allah rewards you. When you raise your hand, say, Ya Rabb, Allah knows you're sincere or not. And you know. Nobody else can know. No shaitan, no angel, no Jibreel alayhi salam. Nobody can have access to know if you are sincere or not. Be sure of this, huh? Shaitan, Iblis himself cannot come beside you. He can whisper only. But does he know that you are sincere in the heart or not? He can't. Because if he knows, he will spoil it. Right? If he knows, he spoil it. He can feel, oh, this person is serious now. He might be sincere, so let me spoil it. But he is not sure. Only one who knows you are sincere is Allah, then you. Nobody else. Nobody else. And you cannot prove to anybody you are sincere. You can't. Can you? Try to prove. They will think you are sincere. You can do many things to make sincere, but maybe it's all a show. So only you after Allah Azza wa Jal. So keep it that way. Wallahu ya'lamu a'malakum. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Wala nabluwannakum." Now the khitab or the address to the believers. Now we talked about munafiqeen now, right? Then Allah Azza wa Jal said, "Now you're going to have a test." They failed in the test, right? And they will lie, and you will know them by their lying. And if we wish, we will show you, right? But now the address is the good people now. "Wala nabluwannakum." We're going to test you. "Hatta na'lam al-mujahideen minkum was-sabirin." Excuse me. "Unabluwa akhbarakum." We are going to keep testing you. Allah here said general. He did not say what he'll test you with. But in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, "Unabluwannakum bishay'in min al-khawf," fear, "wal-ju'a," hunger, "wanaqsin min al-amwal," dearth in money, "wal-thamarat," fruits and food, "wal-anfus," their people, "wabashir al-sabirin." "Am lakum bishay'in min al-khawf wal-ju'a wanaqsin min al-amwal wal-anfus wal-thamarat." People, the fruit and the money, all this will be little as a test. "Wabashir al-sabirin." Glad tidings to the sabirin. "الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة," when a calamity comes to them in all these affairs, قالوا, they say what? "إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون." We belong to Allah, we go back to Him. "أولئك," those, "عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة," the prayers of Allah upon them, رحمة of Allah upon them, "وليكم مهتدون," they will be guided. May Allah make us among them. So here Allah said, "ولنبلونكم" only. But in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, "ولنبلونكم" with what? It can be with what? All right? Also, Allah Azza Jal said, أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا أمنهم لا يفتنون. Fitna, بلاء, يعني ابتلاء. ابتلاء, ابتلى, يبتلي, means testing you. بلاء. بلاء is test. بلوى, مصيبة. You know they call it مصيبة. مصيبة, calamity. So ابتلاء means we'll test you with calamities. Test you with hardship. So when you find somebody their ابتلاء in the spouse, somebody their ابتلاء in the children, somebody their ابتلاء in the health, in their eyesight, in their hearing, somebody is ابتلاء in their money, somebody ابتلاء in their neighbor, in their boss, in their employees, in anything you can. But every one of us sitting here has ابتلاء for sure, yeah. No doubt. Maybe you are not aware of it, but it's happening. Whether you like it or not, there is ابتلاء. So Allah is giving us test to know that nobody can get the perfect package. There is no way. Okay? Ibtila. But you say Alhamdulillah because you see the right, the positive things. But there is ibtila of some kind. حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ. طيب, يعني everybody going for jihad is mujahid. يعني means we know the sincere mujahideen. The true ones. Everybody join the race. Right? But who's going to continue? That is the meaning. Mujahideen is the ones who are going for jihad. When Allah doesn't know who's going for jihad, Allah knows who's going sincerely for jihad. Like Allah alamu a'malakum, Allah knows your deeds. Allah knows who is the true mujahid. Yani when I see, said, everyone is going to recite the Quran, so I can know who's reciting. Well, everybody's reciting, right? But what I mean is, who's good reciting. Okay? Who's reciting good. Who's a good reciter. Let's go pray. Let's see who's praying. Like who truly prays. All right? Let's go to race. Let's see truly who endure. We understand now? لَبْلُوَكُمْ حَتَّى عَمَلْ مُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ. And then we'll see each akhbar. Akhbar means news, يعني. يعني which each one of you what will come up with. Khabar. You know when they say a person come new in town. Huh? A person is new in town. They said, oh, there is a new sheikh in town. You're going to say, let's go and see what is his khabar. You know, khabar means news, يعني, right? Let's see what is the khabar. يعني, we're going to go, he's like news in front of us. News shows you what happened, right? So let me go and say, ما خبره? ما خبره? يعني, مبتدأ and khabar. You know, مبتدأ and khabar? Khabar is the predicate, right? It shows you what happens, يعني, in the sentence. In sentence, there is mubtada that starts the sentence, right, Dr. Khan? Mubtada is the subject. And then you have khabar, like Muhammadun Rajulun. Muhammad is a man, right? So Muhammad, what about him? Rajul, he's a man. Muhammadun Kareemun. So there is a new sheikh in town. What about him? It's like predicate. What is the predicate? Let's go see the khabar. We have the mubtada, let's go see the khabar. We have the fa'il, let us go see the action. Yes. فَوَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ We will know who your true colors. What is matter about you? What's your true value? You can say, I am generous. I am the man. I am the sheikh. I have hadith. Here is my ijaza, my certificate. Al-Azhar graduate. Ah, كل ده جميل. All this is beautiful. Huh? But what is the real khabar? When you ask me a fatwa. Any sheikh can have laptop in front of him like this, you know, and can read from it and can give you knowledge. Anyone can do that. How would you know a true sheikh, knowledgeable or not? Ask questions. So that's why I'm telling you, have good questions all the time. Don't repeat yourself. Go study, my brothers and sisters, study your book, study the book of Allah. Study it well, all right? And when you see a alim or a scholar, you want to know their khabar, ask them a question. All right? Ask the question. They will tell you, they will know they know or they don't know. Even when they tell you, I don't know, you know that they have a value also. They respect what they do. Right? They tell you, I don't know, but I will look for it. Okay? So that's value also. But if they say, وغير علم, you already read more than what they tell you. So who are they now? And you already studied more than what the sheikh tells you. What does that mean? Means he did not read it. Okay? Or he gave you a wrong answer. Or they gave you less answer. Now you know the khabar. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّهُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ We'll know your khabar. What you say, you walk with a walk, or you talk the talk, what you do. Allah Azza wa Jal, of course, here, he is saying to the people of the book, to the munafiqeen, to the hypocrites, then to the believers, it's all about testing. Somebody failed the test, somebody passed the test, true colors come out. When you talk, we know, you know, all these things. So believer is very honest, very straightforward, follow simple rules, and do not lie. Wallahi, solution is simple, isn't it? What you complicate it for yourself, you're gonna suffer. But you become easy. Deen, very easy. Five pillars of Islam, easy, simple. When you are weak, say I'm weak. When you need help, say I need help. When you don't know, say I don't know. When you want to ask, ask. Be simple. And don't lie. Allah gave you tawfiq, Allah will make you grow. You complicate, you become arrogant, you have ego. You say I know and you don't know, you're going to have a problem. You're going to make mistake and you lose the respect of people. Allahu Akbar. So, Allah Azza wa Jal is, there is one of the guided predecessors. His name is Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. This Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad was a thief. Was a thief. And his specialty was to steal from the people going for Hajj. Oh, yes. Ghasb, yes. Only people going for Hajj because they are loaded with money, right? They're going to spend it. They're traveling 1-2 months. His specialty. But he repented, became a scholar, subhanAllah. Wow. Yes. Who knows? Allah maybe put him in this situation. So when he repents, he becomes very soft-hearted. So every ayah of the Quran make him cry. Because he knows what he did, you know? Scared. So he became one of the top scholars of the soul. You know, like, Khalifa will ask him for advice. You know, like that. So when he hears this ayah, he cries a lot. And he says, Allahumma la tabtalina. Ya Allah, please don't test me. Because if you test me, you're going to expose me. Right? I'll be exposed. I'm weak. Right? Allahumma la tabtalina. فَإِنَّكَ إِذَا بَلَوْتَنَا فَضَحْتَنَا وَهَتَكْتَ أَسْتَارَنَا. Ya Allah, thank you for covering us. Please keep us covered. If we are tested, Ya Allah, we might fail. See, he knows his value. So it is very, very important to learn from these things, subhanAllah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَصَدُّوا عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ Look how many things that the kuffar did. Kafaru, number one. They themselves disbelieved. وَصَدُّوا عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ And they prevent people from coming to the path of Allah. وَشَاقُوا الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدَ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الْهُدَى يعني they fight Rasulullah also. Yani not only they disbelieve, that they prevent anybody who wants to believe, and they fight those who believed. three things. Why Allah mentioned three things? To show you that his azab is worth it. يعني they worth the azab of Allah. It's not one deal. Kafaru and they hide on their own. Rasulullah was to beg Quraysh, beg them. You don't want to believe? It's all right. خلوا بيني وبين الناس. Let me talk to people. Why he was hiding and going the Hajj time, talking to one tribe after the other? Because they're preventing him from doing that. Yes? And they don't want anybody to listen to him. Because they know his talk is nice. His talk is haqq. Abu Jahl himself said, Wallahi, I know his prophet. But how come Abd Manaf tribe become prophet? I cannot match that. And I cannot let them beat us. So I know his truth. He never lied. He will lie now. Yani he never lied on our dunya affairs. He will lie about God. There is no way. But the izzah bil ithm. You know izzah bil ithm? Sinful dignity. That is the one. Yes. So they kafaru. They disbelieve, but they don't want anybody to believe. Rasulullah said, you won't disbelieve. Khalas, but let me. Some of them even said, let him go. Expel him somewhere. Let him go. If people don't like him, they kill him. Khalas, they took care of it. And if he wins, you get the credit. We'll say, he's our son. This is, you see, our son guided you. But they could not take it. They said, no, what if he goes and his follower come and they come attack us later? Yeah, they have to stop him. كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله وشاقوا الرسول من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى. You see, Allah is saying, not me. Allah said, they realized that this is guidance. تبين. تبين means somebody searching. You know how you're searching, making a thesis, searching, search. And then the true تبين means I came up with the result. In my PhD, for example, you're making bahth. Bahth. You know, at the end, Dr. Khan, at the thesis, we said, من بعد البحث تبين, يعني after searching, تبين لي, it came out to me, it clear to me, I found out that the result is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After every research, that's what you do, right? As a doctor, you make a research, you said, after looking at these cases, I found out 1, 2, 3, 4. So Allah said, تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الْهُدَى. What does that mean? Beyond the doubt, it was shown that they guide. Yet they decided to fight Rasulullah. شَقُّ الرَّسُولَ. This is a proof. A proof that people of Quraysh were not fighting Rasulullah because they have a different understanding. Or because they have a strong argument. They don't deserve that. And don't say that they had a good argument, but he still fought them. No. They were fighting out of arrogance. It is not fighting because they have the other side of the aisle. Like people said, freedom of opinion. Okay? Freedom of opinion. So freedom of opinion has also a limit here in this country. But fish hagas about unlimited freedom of opinion. يعني freedom of opinion. Can somebody working in the Pentagon has a freedom of opinion to say the secrets of that? Does he have freedom of opinion to do that? Why? Here you go. So please talk with me like this. Don't say freedom of opinion means you can do whatever you want. Huh? So don't say, oh, Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad, he had the sword. That's why he cut everybody who does not follow him. لا طبعا. That was not the case. Abu Jahl himself said, I'm fighting him because I don't want him to be whoever he is. It's not like I'm not convinced. No, I'm convinced he's right. I'm convinced he's right. One of the sheikhs who was tortured in Egypt for his activity. Long time ago, about 30 years ago. He's telling us, he said that one time they took him to the torturing places, those secret people, and they took him to the torturing places. And underground, he does not know. They blindfold them and they take them. They take off their clothes and they put them in a room like alone, like animals. So they take them one by one in the office for interrogation. So he said, I'm sitting blindfolded. They make me sit blindfolded in the desk, and I know that the officer talking to me. But he talked to me from behind me one time, from the side one time, from the scaring, you know? So he goes around the room, you don't know what's gonna happen to you. Then he comes close to you, you think he's gonna do something. Then he said he has plier in his hand. No plier. Yeah, and he comes and he keep pinching him in different places. You know? And he said that while he's doing that, he told him, do you know, Sheikh? Wallah, I love you. And I know you're right. you know what? I know I'm wrong. And you believe that I'm a jund of Iblis. You know jund? Jundi? Like askar, askar, lashkar? Iblis ka lashkar? I am askari of Iblis, yani? I know that. He said, all this I know. And I know you're going to win one day. But I just don't want it to happen now. Just delaying it. So that's what I'm doing, what I'm doing. So forgive me. And he punches him again. You understand? I'm just giving you a picture of how people can do what shaitan is not capable of. Human being. So they know he's right, yet they fight him. They love Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but they don't want him to be Nabi. That is what kufr does. You know, kufr does. Mu'min, you love human beings, even if they disbelieve, as long as they don't hurt you. Correct? We love everybody. We love our neighbors. We love people. We love them to be happy. If they are sick, we make dua to Allah, that Allah guide them and heal them. I told you that before, right? We love people to be good. We do not hate them because they disagree with us. Wallahi, no. We hate the fact that they will die and that they will suffer. We want them to be guided. As long as it's their choice, khalas, no problem. Kafaru, no problem. But here, صدوا عن سبيل الله وشاقوا الرسول. That's why the fighting happens. Not freedom of opinion here. You are fighting us not to exist, so we'll fight you back. Okay? شاقوا الرسول بعد ما تبين له الهدى لن يضر الله شيئا لن يضر الله شيئا. They are not going to harm Allah. وسيحبط أعمالهم. As this guy was saying, I know you will be defeated one day and you will win one day. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Allah will perfect his nur. Surah As-Saffat, if you remember, وَلَقَدْ سَبَقَتْ كَلِمَتُنَا لِعِبَادِنَا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Our word already decided to our guided messengers. إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. Our army is the one that wins, and our messengers are the ones whose kalima will be higher. It's a matter of time, but it will happen. And it has been happening in the history up and down like this. Right? One day for the good people, one day for the bad people. If you look at the dunya, from the history of Adam until our time now, until the day of judgment, wallahi, there is no difference. You will see that people up who are good, and people bad down. Then the people bad come up, and the people up good come down. يعني, this is what the history is going. الأيام دول وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس. Allah did not say between always for believers. Allah said believers eventually win. That means what? They will be defeated sometime. You get it? So don't despair. Sometimes Allah knows that defeat will bring us up. And sometimes Allah knows that up is not for us because we're no good. We have to come down. And sometimes you deserve to go up, so Allah brings you up. So we ask Allah that our iman stays the same, whether we are up or we are down. Remember that. But you act accordingly. Naam. Then Allah Azza wa Jal says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, ati'u Allah, ati'u Rasul. That's very clear. Obey Allah and His Rasul, Quran and Sunnah, do your job. وَلَا تُبْطِلُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ يعني do not nullify your deeds by hypocrisy. يعني صلاة, صيام, زكاة, حج, but then you eat the rights of the people. What is the value of that? You know, ابطال, ابطالة means nullify something, voiding something. You know, ابطالة. ابطالة means some function and you destroy it. So abtalahu, you know that when there is a bomb that is hot, is about to explode, and somebody comes and do what? Disarm it. Abtala. Also, if something good about to take place and somebody pull the plug, there is a wedding here or something like that, and all the lights ready and everything, and everybody is enjoying, and somebody pulls it. Abtala also. So you have good amal, but abtalahu. So لا تبطلوا أعمالكم. You are the ones who can make this أعمال accepted, and you are the ones who can destroy everything by doing bad deeds and hypocrisy and bad intention. إن الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله ثم ماتوا وهم كفار. يعني they have a chance unless they are dead. So they كفروا, yes. Disbelieve, yes. They صدوا, yes. Yes, they prevent people from coming. Even they punished the Muslims. But if they repent before they die, Allah accepted them. Sayyidina Umar was like that. Wasn't he? He was among the people who tortured Ashab al-Nabi. He hated Rasulullah and actually he went to kill him. Yes or no? But what happened at the end? Allah guided him. And he became Umar ibn Khattab. We don't remember this history. We remember who's Umar ibn Khattab after, not before Islam. Right? So Allah is not talking about those who challenged Islam and fought and then they repented. No, repentance count. Repentance erase everything before. That's why Allah says here, ثُمَّ مَاتُوا وَهُمْ كُفَّارُ فَلَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ Allah will never forgive them. So Allah said when dealing with such people, فَلَا تَهِنُوا وَتَدْعُوا إِلَى السَّلْمِ يعني do not go and call for peace while they are attacking you. You have to defend yourself. But if they call for peace, you respond. Allah said in Surah Al-Anfal, you understand? So you do not call for peace while you are upper-handed. Upper-hand. But when they call for peace, yeah, يعني رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم when he went to الحديبية, they called for peace treaty, he accepted. يعني he said, والله I wish if they come in with me with any treaty, I'll accept it. وإن جنحوا للسلم فاجنح لها وتوكل على الله. Allah said in Surah Al-Anfal, if they call for peace, accept. But when your upper hand is there, don't call for peace. Because they are the ones who started it. Okay? They call for peace. يعني you do not go there when you're fighting somebody who's challenging you and insulting you and accusing you and making a bad name for you. And now your chance came to redeem yourself physically in the octagon or martial arts or something like that. And then you say, you know what? I throw the white towel. Yeah, you are winning. يعني you're going to win. And claim your name. Why you throw the white towel? Let him throw the white towel. Okay? You understand now? You throw the white towel. But do not do it while you are upper handed. Wallahu ma'akum. Allah is with you. وَلَنْ يَتَرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ Wallahu ma'akum. وَلَنْ يَتَرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ يَتَرَكُمْ يعني يضيعكم. يتر أعمال الأعمال يعني الله will not waste الله will not waste your deeds وترى يتر يعني wasting that's why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said whoever misses عصر prayer فكأنما وتر أهله وماله as if he lost his family and money. And imagine you are driving somewhere and you lost your family and your money. That's missing Salat al-Asr is like that. Yes, yudayya means waste. Waste your deeds. And imagine you are saving. Then you go to the bank and said, where is my saving? He said, we don't have a record.
In English, belittle.
Yes, belittling means putting down. Now here is wasting altogether. Altogether means your a'mal is not there. Yeah. يضيع يعني Allah will not deny you the reward for your deeds. يعني don't worry. Allah has your deeds in record. Recorded. يعني all of it you will be given. يوفيكم. You know, يوفيكم أعمالكم. يعني Allah will not يتركم أعمالكم. Last ayah. نعم. Huh? Second last ayah. So the ayah here saying تدعو السلام الله معكم ولن يتركم أعمالكم then Allah عز وجل says about this dunya إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب وله طب يعني الحياة الدنيا does not have anything except playing and له we praying we reading Quran now يعني generally it is like that okay إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب وله وإن تؤمنوا وتتقوا it is not going to be لعب وله you understand the ayah يعني don't say oh this dunya is لعب وله طب the time you are reading Quran is لعب وله No. لعب means play. لهو means like distraction. يعني. So لعب ولهو when you are listening to music or when you are doing something idle. But actually if you are playing to train for something good, it's not لعب ولهو. Even playing itself. Even when you have some لهو with your family and all of that, this is a good thing. So what Allah is saying is in general, if you surrender to the dunya, is لعب and لهو. Playing and distraction is no good in it. Except the zikr of Allah, studying, reading Quran, doing salah, That is the time that stays for you. وَإِن تُؤْمِنُوا وَتَتَّقُوا If you believe and you have taqwa to Allah, which is doing the right and avoiding the wrong and having good intention, يُؤْتِكُمْ أُجُورَكُمْ Allah will give you a reward وَلَا يَسْأَلْكُمْ أَمْوَالَكُمْ Allah is not asking you for money for himself. Yeah. وَلَا يَسْأَلْكُمْ أَمْوَالَكُمْ So la'ib is the things that there is no benefit in it from in the future. And lahu is being distracted from serious things. يعني anything that does not have a benefit in the future is called la'ib. يعني whatever you do and there is no benefit that comes out. Okay, so you've done your job and everything, but you are doing some activity that has no benefit. That's called what? La'ib. What is it called? La'ib. يعني it does not result in something beneficial. طيب what is lahu? You have something important to do, instead you are making something else distracted. That's called what? Lahu. So if the child is not doing the homework, yet they're playing video game, it's called what? Lahu. Okay? But if they are playing a video game after doing the homework, it's called la'ib. You understand now? So they are doing a video game, but this video game after they done homework and everything, but what is going to result in the video game? Nothing. But if they read a book, they gain information. If they play a mathematical game, they become smarter, right? But this one destroys the brain cells. It doesn't bring benefit, it's actually bring harm. So that's called a la'ib. But if they leave the homework and do the thing, it's lahu. We understand the difference between lahu and la'ib? Okay. So al-hayat dunya is like that. But if you believe and do this, Allah Azza wa Jalla will not ask you for your money for himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُحْفِكُمْ تَبْخَلُوا يعني الله عز وجل he's saying إِن يَسْأَلْكُمُوهَا يعني he's not gonna ask you all your money فَيُحْفِكُمْ إحفاء means exaggerating in asking something يعني you need to give this you need to give this and you need to give this you see how much I'm behind you until you give هذا يُحْفِكُمْ يعني the sentence like this إن يسألكموها فيحفكم تبخلوا. يعني if Allah asks you everything, you are gonna be بخيل. You said no, I cannot give everything, but that's why Allah asking you 2.5%. حرد means like you are encouraging someone to do something. But here it is more of bothering. يعني it is more of trying to take everything from you. So فَيُحْفِكُمْ يعني he's not exaggerating in the request. Allah saying, give some of your money. Yes, he's not asking you to give more. Because إحفاء is مبالغة, يعني exaggerating in request. You know sometimes the person begging you and he said, please give me something and said, may Allah give it to you, they walk away. Right? But sometimes they keep bugging you. You understand that? هذا اسمه ايه؟ إحفاء. Now if they start pulling your clothes, اسمه إلحاف. اسمه ايه؟ لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. تحسبهم أغنياء من التعفف لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. يعني you think they are rich because they are not like bothering you with asking. You think they are rich but they are poor actually. فقراء يحسبهم الناس أغنياء. People think they are rich, but they are faqir. Why? Because they are not ilhaf. يعني they will not leave until you give them the money. So there is asking, mas'ala, there is ihfa, and there is ilhaf. You know, stages. If you go to hajj, you find those beggars in the street. They come and tell you, haji, this, give me this. And you don't give, they come around you. Ihfa, Then they will pull your clothes. Will hang to you until you give. Once you give, you're doomed, khalas. Because you're going to find 100 people coming, you know. Once your hand put in the pocket, you find they come from, you know, كأنهم فراش مبثوث. يخرجون من الأجداث سراعة. They come out of earth, you don't know how. And I tell people all the time when I go to Hajj, but they don't listen, but they get it. But alhamdulillah, who they do with Allah, Allah accept inshallah. As I told you before, right? When you give, you don't talk. When you talk, you don't give. All right? So you're dealing with Rabbul Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. So لا يسألون الناس إلحاف. So فيحفكم, يعني Allah is not going to ask you and beg you in the مسألة because he knows you're going to be بخيل. That's why Allah wants you to be kareem. He asks you very little. يعني Allah told you zakah is 2.5%. But sadaqah, you can give whatever you want. Say whatever you want. He did not give sadaqah. He said zakah is 2.5% and sadaqah up to 30%. You know, Allah did not calculate the sadaqah. Imagine if Allah calculated the sadaqah, people will not give. You know, if Allah said 30%, nobody is going to give 30%. But when Allah leave it open, some people give 70%. You see? Mentality. You want to be in control. But if Allah make it a fard on you, it becomes a problem. So subhanAllah, 2.5%, we give easy. If it is 5%, imagine if it is 10% of your income. Mushkil. Mushkil. People will not give sadaqah at all. 10%, ya akhi, I give 10% from my income. Okay? But you give sadaqah up to 50, no problem. That's what Allah Azza Jal said. فَيُحْفِكُمْ تَبْخَلُوا وَيُخْرِجْ أَضْغَانَكُمْ. Then Allah will show the real grudge and the real hatred in the heart, subhanAllah. Last ayah, Allah Azza Jal said, هَا أَنْتُمْ هَؤُلَاء. People, يعني تُدْعَوْنَا لِتُنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. You are asked to give fi sabilillah. It will be two groups. One will give generously everything like Abu Bakr, half Umar, everybody else's after that, no problem. Yeah. It's open, as I said. Nobody can belittle what you give. Very little. You give for Allah, nobody can say anything. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accept half date from someone. Bring a date. Munafiqeen said, what Allah need from this one date? And one person give a bundle of gold. They said, oh, hypocrite, he's showing off. Okay? So, يلمزون الناس. يعني the one who gave more, they said he's a show off. The one who gave less, said, what, he's, Allah will take this. لا, you give for Allah, nobody can blame you, nobody can point finger at you. But if you become miser, that's a problem. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يَبْخَلْ. Some of you become بخيل. Miser. كنجوز. بخيل. طيب, ومن يبخل? Who is بخيل? فإنما يبخل عن نفسه. See, this is a very, very, very beautiful statement. You are بخيل for yourself. Who is بخيل for himself? يعني you are preventing yourself from enjoying. البخيل is actually not enjoying his own money. يبخل عن نفسه. يعني if I tell you there is a trade, you give $1,000, you get $2,000. You said, no, I'm not going to do that trade. بخيل, you don't want to spend $1,000. So who lost here? You. So who suffered from بخل? You. First hand. The first one who suffered from his own miserliness is the miser. Not anybody else. Because other people, kareem, they will get. Yeah, you don't offer the job for this person because you don't want to give. He's going to get the job somewhere else. But who suffered? You. Ali ibn Abi Talib, رضي الله عنه said, عجبت للبخيل. I'm wondering about a بخيل. يأتيه الفقر الذي منه هرب ويهرب منها يهرب منه الغنى الذي إياه طلب. يعني the poverty that he ran away from, it catches up with him. And the wealth that he's running after, it runs away from him. يعيش في الدنيا عيشة الفقراء ويحاسب في الآخرة حساب الأغنياء. He lives in this dunya as poor people, but he will be accounted in akhirah as rich people. بخيل. So he's بخيل on himself. He does not want to buy new clothes because if people see him with new clothes, they will ask him for money. Right? He does not want to bring meat and stuff because people will know that he has money. People will smell, oh, he cooks a new goat, means you have money. So he prevents himself from khair. So people cannot ask him for khair. So he himself lives like people. But the problem is he will live like them, but he will be accounted like rich. And after he dies, someone else will enjoy all this money, mashallah. You know? So, a person who spends for Allah's sake, people don't want them to die. But people who are miser, everybody expect their death. Even their own family. Alright? So, Allah Azza wa Jal says, if you go away from the path of Allah, Allah will bring the other people who will become better than you and who will spend, who will not be miser. And they will not be like you. واستبدل قوما غيركم ثم لا يكون. So اللهم لا تستبدلنا. We ask Allah, Ya Allah, don't exchange us with people who are better than us. Ya Allah, make us the better ones. Make us the replacement, not to be replaced. You see? So don't think or don't act in a way that Allah says you will be replaced by someone better. No, I want to be the replacement of someone bad. Okay? So people ignore Quran, we sit here and study Quran until the last breath. So you are the replacement. You don't want to be replaced. We ignore the Quran and we die and somebody come in our place studying the book of Allah. Like we study it. We study it in place of those who did not study it in our generation and the generation before. You understand? Every time you do some good amal and respond to Allah, you are a replacement of someone who did it. Would you want to lose that position? You want to lose that position?
No.
No. This last ayah is talking to those. هَأَنْتُمْ هَأُولَىٰ. Now you are invited to spend for the sake of Allah. Some of you will say, I will not spend. Guess what? Somebody will. Somebody will. It will not stop. Allah will ask, people will respond. So either you choose to be one, or you choose not to be one. But Allah will have someone. And he will not be like you, he will be better. So may Allah make us the better ones all the time. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين.